Today's video, we're going to discuss how to facilitate a live migration of a VM without the need for a dual primary DRBD cluster. Sort of. You actually will require dual primary, but we're only going to use that just when we want to migrate a VM. Otherwise, it's going to run active-passive. Real quick before I get into that, though, just want to touch real quickly on the difference between active-passive and dual primary. An active-passive DRBD configuration means you can only access the data on the one site. You have a master and a slave, and you can only read and write to the data on the master node. The benefits of this is you get a simpler configuration, smaller DRBD resource, shorter pacemaker config. It's potentially safer, because since we can only access the data on one side, we don't have to worry about two nodes trying to write to the same area of a disk, potentially scrambling your data. And it allows automatic failovers via pacemaker. Dual primary configurations going to actually allow you to read and write to the data on both sides, but this is going to be a lot more complex with a lot of additional moving parts. Things like the distributed lock manager, a clusterware file system, proper node level fencing. If you have those things in place, it's safe to do, and many people do in production, but if any of those are misconfigured or misbehave, there is a small potential for data corruption or loss. Dual primary does also allow automatic failures via pacemaker, and for this use case, the big difference is it does allow for live migrations of VMs. But for this demo, we're going to talk about why you don't always need it, or all the additional things like the lock manager and the clusterware file system. And what we do there is we trust the hypervisor. All of these hypervisors have systems to allow live migration with shared storage without the need of clustered file systems or anything of that sort. So we're just going to emulate that here. We trust that the hypervisor won't try to write to the same area of the disk at the same time on two separate nodes. And then just to allow it to access both sides as it needs for the migration, we're only going to go dual primary when needed for the migration. Relatively easy. Fairly simple and straightforward, and if you bear with me real quickly, I'll quickly jump on some test VMs and demonstrate that for you. For this demonstration, we have two bare metal systems named Odin and Thor. These are used as our hypervisors. Odin's currently running a VM named RHEL 7-0. Thor is running one named RHEL 7-1. Both of these VMs are managed by pacemaker. Both of these VMs are backed by DRBD resources. Resource 0 corresponds to the 0 VM. Resource 1 corresponds to the 7-1 VM. Over here I have the RHEL 7-0 VM I'm connected to. You can see this is a KVM type VM. I'll run top over here just so we have some activity going on the screen. Now, to live migrate this VM, it requires two things we need to set, one of which is in the DRBD configuration. That is the allow two primaries equal yes. We're not running dual primary. We're currently running an active passive. As you can see here in pacemaker, we have a master and a slave. And that is reflected in the DRBD status as well. Secondary primary, primary secondary. The other thing we need to set is within the pacemaker configuration. And that is for the virtual domain resource, we need to set the allow migrate equal true option. And once that's set, you can briefly go dual primary and migrate resources. For the sake of this, I'm going to run a little script. I'll share this script in the video description below. It takes two arguments, the DRBD resource and the virtual domain resource. And I'll run this now, and we can watch everything in action. First step is we promote them both to primary. You'll see now we're primary primary in the R0, and you can see here in pacemaker we have now two masters. Next step is to tell the VM to migrate. You'll see right here it switches from Odin to Thor. Next we just need to tell it to go back to active passive. As you can see, we did that, primary, secondary. We now just have a master and a slave on both. And then we'll lastly, we'll remove the constraint we use to migrate the VM. As you'll notice over here, the VM's still chugging along. No interruption. And that's pretty much all we had to do. If you recall, we just promoted it to primary on both sides, moved the VM, and made a secondary again. It's really just that simple. Odin's not running the VM, and now Thor is running both. And that's pretty much all there is to it. It's not too difficult to do.